Hello and welcome to a one-off special Let's Play a video, and this will be a simulation called Jane's 688i Hunter Killer, and we'll play one of the missions. Right, here we go. Let's pick single mission and pick fighter planes don't float. I had a practice run earlier, so this is a combat search and rescue mission. Let's go. Right, on this screen you can buy upgrades, but as we've only just started, we haven't got any money. You can choose the different weapons, so I think that's pretty standard, so let's go with that and get underway. Right, this is the
Con, sonar. I have a new contact, bearing
controls of the ship.
Designated Sierra 1. Con, sonar. I have a new contact.
And we've been
zero,
told there's
zero,
some contacts.
Four, designated Sierra 3.
And there's the Mediterranean Sea, and there's Italy. We zoom in on our ship. Now I've set this on easy, so all the contacts are in view. And S2 looks like a friendly ship. There's one submerged contact, and there's a surface enemy contact. So these are two enemy contacts. If we go to this view, we can see our submarine there. And you can choose the different cameras. Stick with camera 3, I think. If we have this, look at this drop down, that's the pilot we need to pick up. There's an enemy ship there. And there's an enemy submarine. And there's the friendly cargo ship. Right, we're at the right depth, I think. I'm just going to go a little bit higher.
Make my depth 50 feet. Aye, sir.
And slows us down a bit.
Maneuvering, Con. Make turns for 2 knots.
And I'm going to read the message. So we've got to operate in this area. Rules of engagement, peacetime. ROE remain in effect. Recovery of air crews must occur surfaced at speeds less than 2 knots. Should hostages be taken, it would be embarrassing for the US and severely hamper NATO military operations in the region. So if we raise our antenna, we can get new messages. You see that going up there? Let's have a look at the new message. A US F-15 aircraft was lost in the vicinity of 4125N and 01835 East. As a result of damage received over the target area during a strike earlier today. Make best speed to the location. Locate and recover the pilot as soon as possible. A frigate belonging to one of the warring factions. Additionally, a submarine. Yes, we know about that. Okay, let's put our antenna down. If we don't, we'll break it off. So, and we're gonna go low and get our speed up.
51 feet. Aye, sir.
Maneuvering, Con. Make turns for 6 knots.
Now we can speed up time as well. Off we go. Now if we click on this screen, we can see how deep the water is. So there's at least 3,000 feet there, so we're not going to run aground. It's important to increase your speed slowly, because if you go too fast, you'll start to cavitate. That's when the propellers spin too fast for the water and bubbles are created. And then the enemy submarines and frigates will hear you and they'll track you down. So it's very important to keep quiet. Right, we can now increase our speed.
Maneuvering, con. Make turns for 16 knots.
And let's see where those coordinates were again. I wrote it down. I think it was 41.25. 18. So it's about this sort of area. And it's about 30 miles away. And it just happens those enemy ships and contacts are in the way, so I think what we're going to do is we're going to break the rules of contact engagement, and we're going to make this simulation a bit more exciting for the viewers. So if we head due north and engage.
Come right to course 000. Aye, sir. Steady on course 000.
And let's head in the direction of northeast.
Steady on course.
And then we'll be in a good position to shoot a torpedo. Now the torpedoes have a range of about 10 miles. And we're about 11 miles away. I don't really want to be any further out than that, but I want to get into a range of about 5 miles, I think. Now let's increase our speed.
Maneuvering, con, make turns for 26 knots.
Now I've got a feeling we're going to cavitate, so I'm actually going to. Yes, we are. So let's go back down to 22 knots.
No longer cavitating.
Right, we're closing in. Now on a harder difficulty setting you won't see these contacts. You've got to pick them up yourself and identify them. But we've got this on easy. Right, let's slow ourselves down.
Maneuvering, con. Make turns for 2 knots.
What you got to try and do is move fast for a period, slow down, listen out for enemy contacts, and then move fast off again. So, and that's the kind of thing you want to be doing. So we've come to a standstill almost. And let's see this S3 contact on the sonar. Now the hull array isn't as sensitive as the towed array, which we haven't reeled out yet. I'm not going to reel it out, because it's a pain, because you have to reel it back in. If you turn too tightly, it will cut off. So we seem to have lost this submarine. I'm not sure what all these buttons do. We'll keep north center. Maybe it's too far away, so it is a submarine after all, so let's get a bit closer.
Maneuvering, con, make turns for 22 knots.
Come left to course 020. Aye, sir. Steady on
course.
What
we're doing now?
20.
You can actually target this submarine, and this is the weapons screen. And you got 4 torpedo bays. There's 2 harpoons loaded already, and they're anti-ship missiles, so we'll use them later. And there's 2 torpedoes loaded already there. And these are the Tomahawk missiles, so you can target ground targets there. Sometimes you can see the enemy submarines on this screen, but I think we're too far away.
Come left to course. 0, 1, 0. Eyes.
About 5 miles away now.
0, 1, 0.
Let's get a little bit closer. Let's check the depth. That's fine. Now we will be going into shallower waters, so we'll need to keep an eye on the depth. Alright, that's close enough. Let's slow down.
Maneuvering, con. Make turns for 2 knots.
Now he hasn't picked us up, because if he did, he would have turned us round. He would have turned round, and he looks like he might have picked us up. So we're a bit close for comfort here. Let's see if we can listen out for the submarine. S3. That's S3. I'm going to designate that as a target. If we go to this screen and choose. What was that submarine called? Hoji, I think it was. Hiroj. Now you can see all these different profiles I'm clicking on here. And this does match the submarine sound signature. You can use the hull array as well, but we're not pointing in the right direction for it. So we've definitely identified this as the enemy submarine. Right, let's take it out. I can't remember which screen it was. Ah, it's this one. So if we press these buttons, oops. I've got two torpedoes selected. You can change the depth as well. So it's going to launch at a depth of 30 feet. I think we're going to increase this one to 150 and with a floor of 810. So, and we'll keep the other one as a default setting. And let's go to this screen. We're going to flood the torpedo tubes. Press these ones and we'll be ready to fire in a second. And torpedo away. And there's our torpedoes going away.
Unit is running normally. Con, sonar, torpedo in the water. Bearing 001.
Oh, and they've launched a torpedo at us. I'm going to have to just cavitate and get out of here. We're going to change depth.
Make turns
and head
knots.
Due west.
Aye, sir.
Come left to course 270. Aye, sir.
So there's quite a lot of action here. Let's follow one of the torpedoes. I've launched 2 torpedoes. There should be another one there. That's us behind there. There's the other torpedo. I can see the enemy sub there.
Steady on course 270. Cavitating.
Now we can actually launch a decoy, so let's do that.
Con, radio. Recommend copying the broadcast to see if there's any new message drop.
Now we've been told there's some new messages. I'm not going to put my antenna up just yet. Wait, we're running away. Let's check up on our torpedoes. There's one going towards that enemy submarine, I can see it. The other torpedo. I think these are going to miss if we're not careful. Let's see if it's turning towards it. Yes, it is. Well, this is tense. I think taking out enemy submarines must be the hardest thing, because not only have you got to get in close, but they can shoot back at you. I've no idea where the enemy torpedo is at the moment, but I'm just going to follow our torpedoes. And I think we're going to get it. Awesome.
0-2-2 as detonated. Con, sonar, loud explosion, bearing, 0-2.
And our second torpedo's hit as well.
0-2-2.
That's him out. Right, where are we? This is the enemy torpedo, and I think there's no way it's gonna get us. And it's hit the seabed. I think we can come to a stop now.
Con, sonar, loud explosion, bearing, 0-9-0. Con, sonar, loud explosion, bearing, 0-9-0.
And it looks like the enemy submarine has been taken out now. Where are we? If we come due north.
Come right to course. 0-0-0. Aye, sir.
Let's take out this enemy frigate.
Con, sonar, no longer cavitating.
Right, this enemy frigate is about 9 miles away.
Stay on course. 0-0-0.
We're at periscope depth. Let's see if we can see it. So if we raise the periscope, might be just out of range. Bearing of 3-4-5 degrees. We zoom in. No, out of range, so let's get a bit closer. And get up some speed.
Maneuvering, con. Make turn for 22 knots.
3-5-1 feet. Aye, sir.
And off we go. We're slightly off.
Come left to course. 3-1-0. Aye, sir. Come right to course. 0-0.
No, I want to be
steady on course. 0-0-5.
At that kind of course.
Come left to course. 3-2-5.
I think he's trying to run away.
3-2-5. Maneuvering, con.
I think we can afford to cavitate, because we've got the upper hand now. I don't think we're going to catch it, so let's go to the surface.
Make my depth 5-1 feet. Aye, sir.
And target it with the harpoon. think we've got to be at that depth. We're too shallow.
Make my depth 7-1 feet. Aye, sir.
No, we won't fire for some reason. Maybe we're too fast.
Maneuvering, con. Make turns for 2 knots.
Okay. Nope.
Con, sonar. No longer cavitating.
Alright, that's it. That's better. I think we didn't click that tube. So, let's launch. And off it goes. Oh, no. I think we've got to be...
Make my depth.
That was a fail.
1 feet. Aye, sir.
I think we're too deep to launch a harpoon. I think you've got to be at periscope depth. So let's wait. That's better. Let's try again. Target it. And close these up now. Reload. That's it. And launch. Better, see it's going. I follow this harpoon. Should be seeing the frigate any moment now. It does have to travel about 10 miles. Still can't see it. Gotta be patient, I think. Oh, I can see something in the horizon. I think we're off course. Will it turn? Yes. I think this frigate's doomed. There's nowhere to go. There, we've got it.
Con, sonar, explosion bearing 3-2-9.
Pretty awesome, those harpoons. Oh, we've lost it. There it is. Is it going to sink? Shall we launch another one? Well, let's put our radar up and see if we can find
the radar mast.
The aye, down
sir.
Pilot. We need to
raise the antenna. Aye,
get
sir.
Some messages downloaded as well while we're up here. And there's the
radio.
Antenna raised. Let's have a look here. Position reported earlier for downed aircraft was in error. 4130 north. I'll write this down. And 01835 east. Okay.
Lower the antenna. Aye, sir.
Now, I remember the radar can pick it up, so let's see if we can. Might be that one. Let's mark that. And you can see that yellow marker there. So if you mark it, it'll come on the map here. So let's see if that matches. 4130, yes. 01835E. So the radar's already picked it up for us, so we can actually increase the zoom in there. And if we head in that direction, 43 degrees. So let's just set our course there and go
right to course.
At flank speed.
Maneuvering, con. Aye, sir. Make turns for 32 knots.
And off we go.
Con, sonar.
Steady on course.
Cavitate. 0, 4, 3.
Of course, this is not how to do it. You want to sneak around, and but because this is a one-off video and a special YouTube upload, we're going to make it a bit more exciting. So off we go. I wonder if the frigate sunk. It hasn't, but it looks like it's damaged. We can leave it be. So we've got about 10 miles to go. See us there. Oh, time to slow down.
Maneuvering, con. Make turns for 2 knots.
Let's have a look through the periscope. A bearing of 38 degrees, so we should go this way. There it is. Let's come to a stop.
Con, sonar, no longer
con. Make turns for 1 knot.
If we take a picture of it, and then you can compare it to your library. There we are. That's how to identify ships. Mark it.
Con, sonar. I have a new contact.
Sierra 5.
2. Designated Sierra 5.
Not sure what that is. Need to come left a bit.
Come left to course 0, 3.
And it should be just a matter of time now before we pick up this pilot.
Steady on course 0, 3, 3. Maneuvering, con. Make turns for 2 knots.
Con, XO. 0, 0.
Excellent. Right. That should complete the mission now. How do we end this mission? Well, we go to transmit mission report And you need to have the antenna raised to do that, I believe. And our resolution is fair. And it took about half an hour to complete this mission. In real time, it would have took 1.5 hours. So there we have it. We didn't destroy the Grisha frigate. And we were detected by the submarine and the frigate, unfortunately. Used a cheat. The easy options. We played this game in easy, so just for your viewing pleasure. And this is all the events all logged here. And I think, yes, this tracks the whole game. So this is what happened. You see the torpedoes we shot as well, and the harpoons. And there we have it. Close that down. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. Until next time, bye bye.